Exposure to respirable crystalline silica can have serious consequences on employees' health. This is why it's so important for employers to provide the relevant information, instruction, and training to their employees. If employees are likely to be exposed to risks while performing high-risk crystalline silica work, employers must provide information, instruction, and training across three areas. Information, instruction, and training about health risks should cover what illnesses and diseases are associated with overexposure, such as silicosis, the exposure route, and the exposure standard. So, how do you implement the risk controls? Information, instruction, and training about risk controls should cover how to use them and why they are needed. For example, an employee may need to use on-tool dust extraction while drilling into concrete. The information, instruction, and training should explain how to use this system and how it will reduce exposure to crystalline silica. This includes the setup, use, and maintenance of the system, like how and when to clean the filters and replace bags. Let's talk for a moment about implementing the risk controls. Information, instruction, and training about implementing those risk controls should cover how the risk controls are going to be integrated into the workplace and who to ask if there are any questions. It should be done following consultation with the relevant employees and the health and safety representatives. For further information and guidance, visit the WorkSafe website.